Hey, welcome to Light Buckets. This is a quick review of the PowerSeeker 80EQ telescope by Celestron. First off, I'd like to apologize for this big dumb ogre for not knowing how to operate a camera. Let's unbox this thing, shall we? I purchased this scope about a year ago with high hopes of getting better planetary images of Jupiter, Saturn, and Mars. As it turns out, it's spectacular for moon photography also. It showed up in good condition and is well packaged for shipping. Watch out for the little pin that will fall out of the counterweight when you take that out. Kinda like that. You'll know it when you see it, it's the heavy box. The tripod is very lightweight and easy to transport. I maneuvered the entire scope and mount assembly up and down a flight of stairs every time I used it. Its height made it slightly awkward, but other than that, it was easy to move. Getting everything in my car was as simple as retracting the legs of the mount, taking the scope out of the rings, and laying everything flat across the back seat. The focuser is threaded to accept T-rings for prime focus photography. It also has a dovetail finder scope mount if you want to upgrade from the cheapy plastic one that is included. You'll have to find a tightening screw for that, but it shouldn't be too difficult to locate at your local hardware store. About those accessories. This is the 4mm eyepiece. I tried to use it on the first night, but let's face it, it's garbage. It might be useful if you have one of those cell phone holders to take pictures, but putting your eyeball anywhere near this is simply a pain. The 3-power Barlow is, well, garbage. The eyepiece tray is pretty flimsy, and aside from making this video, it never got attached again. The only useful accessory that is included is the 20mm eyepiece. The bottom line is, make sure that you buy some accessories with your new telescope. I recommend the 8-24mm zoom eyepiece, or the Astromaster accessory kit, or both if you can swing it. So what can you expect from this telescope? For eyeball astronomy, it's great for looking at the moon, the planets, and some of the brighter objects in the sky. Its 900mm focal length is perfect for prime focus DSLR moon pictures. For longer exposure photographs, you'll need to upgrade to a motorized mount of some form. Because simply touching anything, including the fine adjustment controls, makes this mount shake like an earthquake. This is the view from my previous backyard. See that little bit right there? At 8mm, with a 2-power Barlow lens, this is what that looks like. And that field is just under 4 miles away. Here is a snapshot of the moon using my Nikon D3400 at prime focus. I added Jupiter and Saturn in the corner for a little size reference. There were fires in the mountains that night, making everything appear yellow from the smoke. But I still walked away with a good video, and with some Registax magic, I turned it into this. After I switched to grayscale, you'd never know about that yellow tinge. I also managed to get some footage of Jupiter and Saturn a couple of nights later, without the smoke. I was still kinda learning at this point, so Saturn was kinda dim. These were my first attempts at processing, before I knew what I was doing. And a year later, I think I've made some pretty good improvements. Today, I would get a much better picture of Saturn, but unfortunately, I traded this scope for the Astromaster 90. For the money, this is one of my favorite telescopes. It's easy to get around and would be a great addition to any camping trip. The accessories are garbage. But to be honest, it's better to purchase them separate anyways. With a tracking mount, I think this would be a great beginner setup. Well, that's all for now. I'm B4Rent, and I'll see you later.